In 2015, I was given the amazing opportunity to travel abroad, seeing the world with a whole new perspective through the Transforming Youth Through Travel scholarship to Paris, France. This trip impacted me personally because of my deep passion for travel, culture, and history. The entire trip was eye-opening, and it made me realize the joys of city life. Before my journey to Paris, I imagined that the never-ending commotion of a metropolitan city would be extremely overwhelming, allowing no room for peace and quiet. However, Paris highlighted many positive aspects of city living that I'd never considered. The convenience of the metro, France's underground transportation, took me by surprise. I could grab a pastry for breakfast at the boulangerie across the street, walk 10 feet and grab a sandwich for lunch at the grocery store, and then hop on the metro and be anywhere in Paris within 30 minutes. While Paris during the day was extremely impressive, the nightlife caused my heart to fall in love. The restaurants in full swing by 9 p.m., the people walking on cobblestone streets, and the aroma of multi-ethnic foods converged with the collage of music made for quite a magical moment. Even though I was surrounded by multitudes of strangers who spoke a language that I could not understand, I never felt out of place. Even more enchanting was the fact that this modern scene exists within a city that is 2,000 years old. Only here could a modern ATM and a 13th century Gothic cathedral coexist within 10 feet of each other. It was literally like history was jumping off the pages of time. Once I traveled to the interior of the city, the architecture around me began to change. I felt like I was going back in time. At the heart of the city is where I discovered the intricate world inscribed into the aging stone walls and glass windows that comprise so many buildings. A world of signatures, insignias, reliefs, motifs, and sculptures. This is the world of symbolism. While many flock to Paris to see Notre Dame and other similar attractions, I experienced my aha moment at 4 Boulevard du Palais, Paris, the address of one of the most remarkable displays of Gothic architecture, loaded with both religious and royal symbolism. Built by French architect Peter de Montereau in 1248 to house Louis IX's collection of holy relics, the Sainte-Chapelle, or Holy Chapel, is a royal medieval Gothic chapel located on the Île de la Cité in the heart of Paris, France. When I entered the lower chapel of Sainte-Chapelle, I quickly noticed a sea of gold fleur-de-lis symbols of French royalty on the ceiling and pillars within the chapel. I imagine what it would be like to be a noble in the 13th century with the privilege of attending mass here. Upon entering the main chapel, I was left speechless. I was taken aback by the height of the ribbed vault ceilings, which were complemented by 15 stained glass windows illuminated by the light outside. In contrast to other Gothic churches like Notre Dame, which showcase circular rose windows, the stained glass windows are especially unique in this chapel because they extend nearly the length of the floor to the ceiling. Every wall and window was filled with both biblical and royal stories, whose timeline include everything from Jesus' birth to the day when Louis IX brought the holy relics, notably the crown of thorns, to the chapel. Because of high literacy rates among the poor during the medieval period, stained glass windows were constructed to explain the biblical stories through pictures rather than words. What caught my attention were the 12 apostles which lean on the columns separating the stained glass windows. It seems to me that the architect put the apostles near the pillars to symbolize them physically and spiritually supporting the early Christian church. This technique of using sculptures to depict important religious patrons within a church is noticeable in other religious sites across Paris. During the medieval era, many architects placed sculptures of saints within the design of the church to express their importance to the specific church or the religious scene as a whole. As I continued to survey the chapel, this time I noticed a sea of stars above my head, in contrast to the fleur-de-lis on the ceiling of the lower floor. It is intriguing that the nobles who entered on the lower level looked up and saw royalty, symbolized by the fleur-de-lis. But when the king looked up, he saw the heavens, or God, represented by the sea of stars on the ceiling of the main chapel. What a perfect portrayal of French social class during the Middle Ages. At this point in my journey, I felt that I was connecting with an earlier form of Christianity. I thought to myself, the people that have gone before me and contributed to what Christianity is today stood in this very room. And that moment of surveying the stained glass windows and touching the walls with centuries of history behind them, I connected with a portion of who I am. As I stood there, I thought to myself, this is where my faith began, and now I get the privilege of standing here. I have had many amazing personal experiences in Paris, even down to navigating the fast-paced metro, sipping hot chocolate in the corner cafes, and eating escargot. I got to experience the French's love for food at the expansive, fresh food market. I was also deeply inspired by the backgrounds and stories of the many context staff and seminar docents, all of whom are passionate world travelers as well, who made this journey possible. Now that I'm back in the United States, seeing pictures of the popular sites in Paris means so much more to me. I think to myself, I know where that is. I went down that road. I know the name of that street, or I know the name of the nearest metro stop. Paris is no longer some faraway dream that maybe someday I will accomplish. No, it is now a reality. The journey to Paris has been an experience of a lifetime. Stepping into the pages of history within places like Sainte-Chapelle, Notre Dame, and Versailles, just to name a few, has affirmed my love for travel and has spurred my love for cultural history, which I hope to study in college. This experience has transformed me and taught me that every day can be an adventure. What I saw and experienced is something I will truly never forget. Don't worry, Paris. I'll be back for you.
Jessica Hardy traveled to Paris, France as part of the 2015 Context Travel SAC High Transforming Youth Through Travel Scholarship, which each year selects a high-performing student from Sacramento High School for an 11-day immersion in French life and culture. The purpose of the scholarship is to expose these students to the rich history of Europe so that it might transform their thinking and studies and perhaps change their lives. The scholarship is funded by the Context Foundation for Sustainable Travel, a U.S.-based charitable organization that seeks to improve travel through innovative projects.